Bear Down Bears fans, we're here to talk about three keys to a Chicago Bears victory versus the Minnesota Vikings, and it starts right now. If you are new to the channel, please like the video, please subscribe to the page, because we do talk Chicago sports weekly. We don't want you to miss a thing, so make sure that you hit that bell. Also, make sure you show love to the fine people over at Martinelli Originals. They're the people that supply these lovely Chicago Bears, Chicago Bulls logo heads for the studio. We don't want you guys to miss out on that, so check them out in the link below. Also, check out what's going on over at obviousshirts.com. obviousshirts.com, the home of the obvious slogans that you just gotta say if you're a Chicago sports fan. Everything from Javi Baez is good at baseball to Khalil Mack will sack your quarterback. So make sure you go down there and enter the promo code TheBreeze10 at checkout to get 10% off your purchase. Now, let's get to the show. So, when I tell you these keys are getting tougher and tougher to do every week, just because I'm like, man, even when the Bears get the keys right, we still lose. They got all the keys right last week. We still lost. But I am going to give you three keys to a Chicago Bears victory versus the Vikings. Key number one, that man Delvin Cook is a problem. He is a problem. Do not allow him to get to the outside. And the reason I say that is, look what the Bears did last week versus Derrick Henry, somebody who primarily was trying to run the ball inside. They were really able to slow King Henry down, which was a surprise to a lot of people, I think. You held Derrick Henry to 66 yards, about 3.5 yards an attempt, and that is very un-Derrick Henry-like. And so if you are able to contain Delvin Cook, not stop him, but contain him from getting to the outside, I think you'll really be able to slow him down, especially if you're sending him right up the middle to where your biggest dogs are. And so now in situations like this, I'm looking at guys like Roquan Smith, who has been playing on another level these last couple of weeks. I mean, he is honestly turning this into the season of his life, a season where, you know, it didn't start off as pretty at the linebacker position, especially in coverage, but Roquan Smith has really turned it around. This is going to be very big for him to force Delvin Cook to stay inside, especially if he's really just trying to get those stretch runs, those outside runs going. I think Roquan will be a key piece to shutting that down. And of course, if Khalil Mack and Akeem Hicks are able to get into the backfield, that definitely causes some disruption too. The biggest thing is keeping him under that century mark. Every game that he's gotten over 100 yards rushing, the Vikings have won. And of course, rightfully so. I mean, he had over 200 yards last week, so of course you're going to get some W's there. But the thing is, his running opens up so much more for Kirk Cousins, which brings us to key number two. But before we get there, I want to know how you guys feel. What do you guys think is the key to a Chicago Bears victory? Let me know in the comments below. I'll be down there talking with each and every one of you. Now, key number two. Key number two for me is force Kirk Cousins to be Kirk Cousins. And what I mean by that is they have not been throwing the ball a ton with Kirk Cousins. Their entire offense for most of this year, now that Delvin Cook is back, has been, let's turn this thing around. Let's hand the ball to Delvin Cook and let's see what he does. Up, he ran for 100 yards. Great. And so Kirk Cousins is only getting about 20, I believe the week before last, he had 14 pass attempts. They've really minimized his role in the offense, but here's the problem. The passes he is getting, he's able to complete at a high clip, and he's able to complete high, efficient passes that are doing a ton of damage to defenses that really are break-you-down passes. Now, we are still coming in with a top 10 pass defense. We've seen that this defense can be kind of bend but don't break against the pass at times. Here's a time where you have to stop Kirk Cousins 110%, because if Delvin Cook is able to wiggle out to the outside and able to break those big runs off, you want to at least make them completely one-dimensional so that they're not breaking those chunk plays off. You know what I'm saying? Those huge plays that are killing you on both pass and run. So to me, really getting into the backfield, getting into Kirk Cousins' head, which is not the toughest thing to do, especially with this Bears defense. You got a Kirk Cousins coming in here who has never beaten the Chicago Bears since he has been in Minnesota. And honestly, I think that's something that could continue if this defense is able to slow down Delvin Cook and really, really contain Kirk Cousins, especially because we know he'll put a pass out there that will absolutely be able to be intercepted. You have to capitalize on that. You have to capitalize on that. And I think that if you're able to get to him, if you're able to rock him a little bit, they'll start to go away from him, start to make it one-dimensional, because even the Vikings know that Kirk Cousins is liable to throw a pick if he starts to get hit like that. So let's try to take him completely out of the game, have him completely not be a factor, and then we can focus in on Delvin Cook. Now, key number three for me, and probably the most important key for this Bears team as a whole. Now, you have Bill Lazor calling plays this week, and so you're hoping that the practice rhythm that happens with Nick Foles and Bill Lazor, that apparently has been happening every week since the season started, carries itself to the field. And we have to sustain that rhythm. Now, I know a lot of people, myself included, are saying, well, switching to Bill Lazor does not change the fact that your offensive line has been trash. Those players specifically have been trash. Switching to Bill Lazor isn't all of a sudden going to make these guys figure out how to play football. But the thing that can change is if you're able to build a rhythm, if you're able to get these guys into a groove, if you're able to get these guys into a rhythm, things could change in that scenario. You could be able to get Nick Foles. If Nick Foles is finally able to get his offensive rhythm in the state that he wanted it in with Matt Nagy calling the plays the whole time. I mean, we saw Nick, you know, go to the sidelines like, why are we calling timeout here? What are we doing here? We need to keep going here. Let's keep our foot on the pedal here. We got something moving. This is a very, very rhythm team. And so hopefully that bringing in Bill Lazor as the OC is going to help that. And so the key to me is keep the rhythm offensively. Key number three, keep the rhythm offensively. When you find that groove, do not lose it, because we've seen that when the Bears are able to find that groove, they're able to move the ball down the field, and it actually looks like a legit offense. It actually looks beautiful. Move the ball down the field in rhythm, because that is going to help this offensive line more than anything than anybody can do. I mean, you're not going to put in better pieces right now. You might get some guys back from injury who could help, but I mean, they weren't that great before injury. But I think that if you're able to get into that offensive groove, now you're able to get the running game going. Now you're able to protect Nick Foles. Now he's able to get his game going. And those are the things that the Bears haven't been able to do consistently, which is why their offense has been in the bottom of the NFL. To me, the most important thing you can do is get these guys comfortable and just allow them to play their game. That goes for everybody on the offensive side. Darnell Mooney, Allen Robinson. If these guys are in their groove, if they're in their rhythm, it is going to be a different game Sunday. And a game that I think is very winnable, because the Chicago Bears have done a great job versus the Minnesota Vikings. They're a team that you know what's coming in, you know what's coming to town, and you know how to beat this team. Let's do it again. Come on now, bear down, y'all. But those are my three keys to a Chicago Bears victory. I want to know your thoughts. Let me know in the comments below, what do you think the keys are to a Chicago Bears victory? And please don't say bring a gun, or don't show up, or everybody on the other team gets COVID. Give me some real keys so that we can have a conversation, a real good debate. You know what I'm saying? I am going to get up out of here. This is your boy, Pat the Designer, back at it again to continue watching our content. Click the playlist here to watch through all of our Chicago Bears content, or click the link here, the links below. As always, y'all stay safe out there in Chicago. Peace.